This is number one champion sound. Yeah, Estelle, we're about to get down.
Get down.
I'm tired of being stepped on all the time. I take a lot of crap from a lot of people, but I refuse to take it from Sebastian, the criminal chipmunk. So I've been sitting here for the last hour, making a list of ways to get back at him.
Well, today's your lucky day, because Auntie Snakes just arrived on the Bitchtown Express. Now, my suggestion is that we drag him bound and gagged to a tattoo parlor for a tramp stamp that reads tips appreciated or congratulations, you're my 1,000th customer.
After what he did to Blaine, I really wanted to hurt him. But I can't. I fought against violence at this school for too long. I have to take the high road.
You know what, Prancy Smurf, I respect that. You're probably right. I want to go to a college that isn't a FEMA trailer and a prison yard, so let's take the high road. We're not going to beat Sebastian by playing dirty, but we are going to beat him.
Hey, Andrew McCarthy. Don't know if you heard, but Blaine may lose an eye. The same Blaine who was just besties with most of you not 4 months ago.
Waiter, are you serious? Is he going to be okay?
Well, sure, if he doesn't care about seeing in three dimensions.
Trent, I got this. Bummer about Blaine. He was pretty. He shouldn't have gotten in the way, though. That slushie was meant for Kurt.
You may look like the villain out of a cheesy 80s high school movie, but you should know that I am fully prepared to go all Danny LaRusso on your ass. Admit you put something in that slushie. What was it, huh? Glass? Asphalt?
Red dye number 6.
You're a liar. Now tell me the truth. What did you put in that slushie?
Rock salt. But it's okay.
Why is it okay? I just told you that Blaine had to have surgery.
Yes, I taped it to my underboob when we went to Dalton, and I got Sebastian on tape admitting that there was rock salt in that slushy that blinded Blaine. Now all we have to do is send this tape to the popo, and that little bitch let us headed to juvie.
I really like your outfit. I think you're, like, fabulous, and I just love everything that you do.
Why, thank you, Britt.
A unicorn is somebody who knows they're magical and isn't afraid to show it. We went through hell last year, and you never forgot how special you were.
Well, Britt, I have to say that I'm flattered and really excited.
Cool. Okay, I'll come over after school, and we'll work on your campaign posters. I got a lot of great ideas.
Great. Great. I'll see you then.
Sweet.
Well, we're here.
We got something to settle. Both of us want to use MJ, but only one can.
We're having a Jackson off Nick at night. Winner gets the King of Pop for regionals.
Well, us against the two of you? You really think you're that bad? Is that what they teach at that little public school of yours?
It's time to see who's bad.
Devil in a red dress. Perfect, and it's totally appropriate for your personality. I have no criticisms. Go with God, Satan. Santana. But I just feel like if I start seeing someone else or even just go on a date, that I'll be admitting that it's over. And I don't want to do that.
You know, these man's bars are delicious, but you have to eat them. If you just hold them in your hand, hoping that you might get to eat them one day, they're going to melt. Then you'll look like somebody just pooped in your hand. Don't let waiting for things to maybe work out with Blaine turn you into the guy who looks like somebody just pooped in your hand.
I've missed you, Britt.
I know, I'm awesome. Everybody wants
a thrill. Oh, young love.
Do you remember when you first started dating Santana and I started dating Kurt? Back before everyone was so busy and so far away, things were so much simpler. We had so much more hope and innocence. Every day was just like Valentine's Day.
We're still young. Shouldn't we still be experiencing those things?
I'm here to help, okay? And Britt, you've got to trust me when I say that everything is gonna be fine. It's okay to have a little anxiety before your wedding.
Congratulations, Blaine Warbler.
Thank you, Britt. You see me cry.
I believe in you and Santana. You remind me of Blaine and me.
Except for the fact that she and I are actually still together.
Your class president for life.
Brittany, who are you talking to?
I thought I was doing a voiceover.
Okay.
So, how's Santana?
She's good. She's just really busy with cheerleading practice and
It's hard making out over Skype. You can't really scissor a webcam.
Here's an extra hot soy latte for him and a no chocolate for her.
Merci.
Ugh, Santana, I feel like such a fool. I just wanted to get outside of myself, you know, let myself be free for once. And look what happened. Everything, including my collection of Broadway playbills, was stolen. I've never felt so ashamed.
That's why I could never live here. Bushwick is worse than Lima Heights.
You can't tell anyone about this. Or even though Blaine and I are broken up, you can never tell him, promise me.
I promise.
I think I can take a couple of queers and a girl.
Okay. See, here's what's gonna go down. Two choices. You stay here and I crack one of your nuts, right or left, that's your choice. Or you walk away and live to be a douchebag another day. Oh, and also, I have razor blades hidden in my hair. Mm-hmm. Tons, just all up in there.
Mm-hmm. We could handle that.
It was more fun doing it together.
Up till now, it's the light of day. Yeah, I wanna dance with somebody.
Oh my gosh, it's my pretty princess deluxe all dressed up styling head. Ah, Santana, I love it. Thank you so much. Oh, I had one of these when I was 10 and I was obsessed with her. I gave this lady smoky eyes every day.
Well, Merry Christmas, Lady Hummel. Now you can relive all of your Jeffrey Dahmer fantasies in the privacy of your own home. But that's not it, because additionally, I am giving you an all-expense-paid trip to Dildo Island. It's a real place. It's in Canada. I got you the deluxe bachelor package.
I think this calls for another glass of my world-famous eggnog.
Yes.
Huh? I'm using Giada's new recipe, but you tell me if it's too much allspice.
Cheers. Cheers.
This one's for you, Brittany.
So give me a chance, because you're all I need, girl.
What? Blind item. Liar, liar. Fanny on fire. What Broadway starlet has been calling in sick while secretly pursuing other job opportunities? Unnamed sources say producers are none too happy with the burgeoning diva's shenanigans and wager that this starlet will burn out faster than you can say Milwaukee Dinner Theater in the round. How'd she do it? Two things. Publicist and a cause.
She can't afford a publicist.
And I've always been my cause.
Inside voice, honey.
Well, you don't need a publicist when you've got snicks on your side. If there's one thing I know about, it's cultivating an image. In high school, I was a huge bitch, but also most popular. I was voted best shoulder to cry on and most likely to poison someone.
Sorry, Mr. Shu. We were just trying to help Brittany out.
I don't smell raspberry hair gel. Does anybody know where Blaine Warbler is?
I would like to personally and publicly congratulate President Brittany. The people have spoken, and they want you, Britt. They want pixie sticks. Rule wisely. Rule fabulously.
You're still the most unicorn of them all, so.
Say that you love me. Say that you need me. Say that you want me. I want you to know.
I want to know.
I said I want you to know right now. A little bit softer now. A little bit softer now. A little bit softer now.
Dream that I
the same anniversary now.
I can't. Wait, hold up.
What was that?
Yeah, you guys, we're in this together now.
Okay, you can count on us. And I think we should make a pact to celebrate our anniversaries together every year for the rest of our lives.
Or maybe like every fifth year?
Okay.
Okay.
Skype,
we can Skype like every year.
Sure.
Every year. Take me on a trip I'd like to go someday.